So, okay, let's continue with USB over STM32 family. So now you've got, I think, a good overview of what we've got as a USB. Let's see in all our family what is covered. So USB full speed available on all STM32 families. That means what we call families for us is the family L for low powers. We've got the mainstream with the Serie F, and then you've got the mainstream and the high performance one with the most powerful one. So it's in all our family we've got a USB full speed, but not on all devices. We've got some device without a USB anymore, so you have to check what you want to do. Crystalless implementation, I think we insist a lot of these capabilities on some parts. We will see after more details about it. So the capabilities, I would say, to have a device without have an external oscillators added in your design. Then the fact that you've got internal pull-up on D plus line, it's not on all them. You've got some who you need to add yourself this pull-up. So Lubos also addressed this during the hardware design this morning. High speed support on the high performance family, and it requires an external fee, except on one family with the F7X3, which embedded an high speed fee. So it could be interesting, you want these features, we've got one part who support it. Here is a map, so with a different family, general purpose one, the high performance and the low powers. Here you can see what are the capability from the crystalless. So we can see that high performance will address all the OTG, posture, host, and the high speed interface, and with the usage of an external fee. I would say this sum up situation today, but it needs to be updated as soon as we've got a new part. So don't take it as I would say a Bible. You still need to check when we see a new reference what is available on it. So for the device-only peripheral, so on the older families, on the little package, so a maximum of 8 bidirectional endpoint, including the endpoint 0. So it's a limitation. If you were remembered in our theory of USB, we say we can go up to 16. But here we are limited by our to 8 bidirectional. Support only of full speed for this device. And in the device-only peripheral, I mean not the OTG one, you don't have the FIFO, you have got a dedicated SRAM, and this SRAM could be shared with a CAN device if it's present on the part. So you have to take care about this when you select a product. If you want to do CAN and USB at the same time, you have to share the memory, and we will see after more details. Link with the power management and the battery charging detection support on some device also. So here's a sum up. So here you've got the size of the buffer available and if it's shared or not with the CAN. And you can see that sometimes if you are using USB, you can't use CAN at the same time. So just to warn you about this, when you select a product, and if you want to use CAN and USB, please check before. For the OTG peripheral, here we've got a dedicated DMA controller. So I think you remember Lubos presented you the difference yesterday on the fact that you have access to the buses, so you can drive a DMA. OTG, internal pull down for the full speed. So no need to add external, and it's needed to switch from host from full speed to high speed. Dedicated FIFO, I think we already covered it yesterday. So here is a sum up of all, I would say, the capabilities for the different family. So it could be limited to 8 endpoints. And the FIFO size, which is 124K. And if you go in the, I would say, high performance one, in the high speed, you can go to 4K for the FIFO, and the number of endpoints is 16. On your slide version, there is a mistake there. It was right 18, but it need to be updated. It was 16, just a typo error. Sorry for that. So, yes, to notice that on H7, you can have two OTG high speed. So there is two OTG high speed, but they are the same properties, so but only one could be high speed. If one is high speed, the other one could be low speed, but not high speed and high speed.
Only the DMA is
capable. Yeah. So that's just to give you an overview of the different capability we see together. I think that's all for this part. Any question on these parts? I would say just information for you after, you really have to check when you want to select, and don't hesitate to use the finders to find the chip or to see what you need to address. I think we switch to another hands-on with Lubosch.